Hello and welcome back to Let's Play Lords of the Fallen with me, Bragget Dawn. We're going to fight the Red Reaper, but at a better location. That was weird. We're going to do it here in the first boss location. I never saw that one. And before now, we've only seen him, well, this should be the first one that we saw. But we only ever saw the Light Reaper fighting Paladin Isaac, right? We have some time to kill, so hoping some of these guys show up. I could have started the episode once he spawned. Also, I think being in this area makes the armor entities weaker. So it won't matter as much if the Red Reaper keeps spawning him. Well, he's not spawning him, but he just keeps spawning. I'm dodging my attacks. Here we go. Now this guy might get in the way trying to fight him. I'm sure I'll accidentally lock onto him in combat instead of whoever I'm trying to target. But this is a nice open arena. The enemies don't despawn in it, so it's already two advantages in my favor. Not that despawning enemies would normally be a disadvantage, but since it caused the Red Reaper to reset, it's a little problematic. Yes! Yeah, this will be a good place to fight the Reaper. Take him down. I'm getting worse at those attacks. Nice. Went exactly how I wanted it to. Oh, you're not gonna do this again. You get so much more dodgy when, about to die.
Mm-hmm.
Well, we did it. It was far, far easier in this area than it was in the other areas. Well, done, I'm done. And so I guess you can keep farming for 3 times vigor, if you were so inclined. Alright, well, let's go and upgrade our character. And, 45 radiance. Heck yeah. I would have preferred to have beaten him more naturally, but I definitely would have in our previous encounter had he not reset, because I entered that one room. Though not really happy about that. Alright, let's grab probably Fire Ward in this area. There's something walking around. Or maybe it's just the lava that I'm hearing. Time out, everybody. I hit X, but my character just didn't use his Sanguinarix. It's fine. Not today. To your keister cooked. Hey, I didn't look at the Umbral Eye that I got from the Red Reaper. Seen that before. I need to sell some stuff. My inventory is getting a little cluttered. Umbral Eye of Marco the X. So, cursed in form, your presence in Umbral is both noticed and feared. Plus one Soulflate charge. It's a secondary effect. Well, that seems really good. Noticed and feared. I wonder what that means. I know what the words mean. What if enemies are afraid of you, but they spawn more frequently? Or you build up the, dread meter faster? Sellsword. I'm gonna go to Guardian for a bit. So this is definitely the way forward, right? We saw a path back this way. I think we can hopscotch across the rocks. Well, maybe not. It doesn't actually look safe, so I'm not sure. I'll just make note of this area and come back here later if I need to. It kind of looks like we can make it, but also kind of looks like we can't. I mean, there is a save point right back there, so even if I die, it'd be alright, but despite evidence to the contrary, I am trying not to die. One of those annoying skull guys down there. Well, let's go beat him up, I guess. I gotta do something dumb. Just asking for it. I was trying to show off, but he didn't let me. You're messing me up. Did a ton of damage. Yeah, fire's not the strongest defense. In fact, I offer zero fire protection. That's part of the problem. Want to go for aesthetics or utility? I think we all know the answer to that question. I will change nothing. So why would we come in this direction? It's coming up roll anyway, jerk.
Justin and the snuff boys buffling along, singing the snuffling song.
Hey yo, what's that?
Oh, must be me lucky.
Oh, son of a gun. I should have known. Justin died? Did not do his quest correctly? Should not have to go back over there. I don't think there's any loot that I missed over here, so we'll go this way instead. Infernal Slash. Screw those guys. I really can't emphasize that enough. By far the worst enemy type in the game. Oh, whoop. That was the wrong thing. Alright, come here, you. Nice. Yeah, somehow threw it through the things, but it's still healing me, so. All's well that ends well. It says elevator leading upward. Of course it doesn't. Hand's cursed effigy. We can go through here, we saw earlier. All right, Geronimo! That'll come down to get us. Cool, now we're over here. Yeah, I thought so. So that's definitely the way forward. Let's go back this way. I want to confirm that ladder that went down goes down where I think it does. Yeah, right here. Perfect. We already have a seedling here, so that works out tremendously. How close am I to being able to... Oh, pretty close. Picked up a skull. I don't know what value it has. I need a little bit more. Yeah, let's see how to do that. Level up real quick. There's something I was interested in using that required 12 agility, right? Alright, we'll keep doing strength until 50, and then radiance still 50. You know what? I'm gonna call it here. I think it's a good stopping point before we proceed further into Brammas Castle. So we made a good amount of progress. We made it all the way through this entire section. Pretty sure we got everything that we could. Didn't miss anything. So next time we will enter the that stairwell and continue deeper into the castle. But for now, thanks for watching. Hope to see you guys in the next one.